Hello to everybody, my name is Stefano and welcome to this episode of the Think and Analyze podcast. So today we have the following question. When is it the right time to do something? Now I feel this episode might be useful to everybody, especially to those who tend to think a lot, myself included. As a matter of fact, once I found the answer to this, I became much more happy with myself. But I'll explain better towards the end of the episode. Back to the question. Generally, I would say that if you are trying to find the right time to do something, that's because you want to do it well, whatever that may be. And so you are looking for the right time in order to maximize your results. And that actually makes a lot of sense, right? Why would you want to do something when you have a lesser chance to succeed? Now, in order to analyze this question properly, you need to ask yourself, what do you mean with right time? Do you mean like having a fair chance of succeeding, or do you mean having the perfect chance, the most favorable situation? Why am I asking this? Because in my experience, the perfect time never comes, and even if it does, the probability is very low. So, if you are constantly waiting for the perfect time to act, chances are that you either 1. Will never act, because, like I said, the perfect time never comes, or 2, you'll have to wait such a long time before the situation is absolutely favorable that you will waste a lot of your time. Additionally, you'll end up investing a lot of energy in order to be well prepared to act, and you create a lot of expectations. So you need to change your idea of right time, and I believe what you need to change it into is the first option I was talking about before, that is having a fair chance of succeeding. Some may argue that you should try even if you have a very small probability of success, but I would say that I believe that that is true. But I would say that generally, the fair chance is what you're looking for. If there is a small probability, in some cases you may even have to try. The best choice might even to try, but generally speaking, you are looking for the fair chance, okay? Having said that, now I'm going to talk to you about my experience with this. Okay, so some years ago, mainly during high school, because that was where I spent most of my time and there were many people there, so I'll talk about this. I would see some of my classmates doing things that I regarded as cool every once in a while, and I would simply watch them without taking part in those activities. We are talking about first and second year of school, because here in Italy we have 5 years. So that meant that I also didn't know very much about my classmates, okay? And so I didn't know them so well that maybe I could have been already friends with them in the, with some deep bond. After some time, however, I started realizing that I also wanted to do fun things with people. However, the other funny classmates would sort of attract most of the other people in my class. So I used to think that I couldn't do funny things because I didn't have anyone to do them with. And to an extent, I was right, meaning that usually it's impossible to have the kind of fun you have when you're in a group while being alone. However, I started from the wrong perspective because, and I clearly remember thinking this, I thought that to have fun, I had to have the right friends. And if you get to the root of this belief, you find that basically, I was looking for the right time to have fun, with right time being only when I got good friends. Now, is it true that if I had good friends who preferred having fun with me, I would have actually had fun? Probably yes. However, that is not the point. Instead of debating on this, I should have actually tried to have fun. Like, if my objective is to have fun, I try to find a way to have it. I don't waste my time thinking if. So what should I have done? I believe I had to be able to self-amuse in the first place. As a matter of fact, if you can have fun alone, you'll surely bring positive vibes when you are with other people. But if you can't self-amuse in the first place, People will generally feel it, and it will be hard to be part of a group because people will feel that you aren't actually at ease with yourself in the first place. And that's actually it, because everything that comes forth is just part of the process of you having fun regardless of how many people you're with. Because then, people will be more willing to follow you because they will sense the positivity around you. And so, step by step, you will have the chance to have more and more fun. A little side note, while hearing of this, all of this, you may wonder if my classmates I was talking about in the beginning had to go through the same process I just talked about. I mean, same process, it is just a one-step process, but it is always a process. Now, something I forgot to say is that a few of them already knew each other since they were even younger. However, I truly believe that those who didn't know anyone did exactly the same process. They wanted to have fun, so they went for it. And they didn't waste time thinking, what if. They simply wanted to have fun, they were at ease with themselves, and so they went for it. The group of people around them knew that, felt that sort of positivity coming from the sort of new member of the group, and they introduced them to the group with no problem. Now, I also want to say that this theme of waiting for the right time very much resembles that of idealizing things. And pay careful attention here. There are situations in which we can't really talk about waiting for the perfect moment to do something. However, we could talk about idealizing something so that when we have that something in front of us, we consider it wrong or bad because we believe it should be perfect. It should be as idealized as we are idealizing it. And that's a bad problem as well. And I believe I will talk about this in the next episode because it is it closely relates to this one. And I believe I should do already another episode which sort of addresses the whole problem. One last thing. At the beginning of this episode, I said that once I found the answer to the question, I became much more happy. And that's true because I finally realized that to do what I wanted, I didn't need to wait a particular time. For this reason, I actually ended up doing what I wanted without always fearing that the situation was not optimal, without always sort of complaining about the fact that I didn't have quote-unquote those kind of friends. And I genuinely believe in what I'm saying because after some time, I went through the same process. Even if consciously, because I believe that usually people, well, maybe people don't even go through the same process, but I mean, they are sort of in the right situation, in the correct situation right at the beginning. But I believe that if one is not, they go through the same process unconsciously, sooner or later. I sort of did this consciously instead because I watched some videos. I tried to learn how all those sort of mechanics works, but in the end, it all worked out quite well. And even if it's not the best like step-by-step guide, what I just told you, I honestly believe it can help you very much. Now, I want to add the following because I believe I may have overlooked an aspect. When I say self-amuse, I do not mean try to have fun only while being alone. And to be more specific, I do not mean that you actually have the kind of fun you would have in company while being alone. I believe that that is actually, as I said before, quite hard. And so some of you may tell me, yeah, but if you are not alone, there's no way out of it. You can't have, if you are alone, there's no way out of it. You can't have actually fun like you would have with friends or with a group. And that's true. However, the sort of principle, the point of being able to self-amuse is to have the right approach to reality, regardless of the situation. Because if you are able to have fun while being alone, and so to be positive while you are alone, as I said before, you will create this positive vibe around you, and people will realize this. People will say, okay, but if he's able to have fun alone, then we will have even more fun, surely, if we are in two or even more people. That's the objective of being able to self-amuse. If you yourself are go to, I don't know, to the grocery shop, you buy something quite funny happens, but you are sort of approaching reality in a negative way, so you actually don't care and you return home and you get on regardless. And the next day when you meet your friends, sort of you will not have anything to talk about. Instead, if you had the positive approach to reality, and that same something happened in the grocery shop, you sort of have this right approach, and so you find it funny, and so when you meet your friends, you talk with them about something, and they will feel that positive vibe, and you will attract people into your life. That's what I mean. Sorry if I make some repetition, but it's always hard to say these kind of things. And one final thing, I genuinely do not believe that what I told you is to trick people into believing that you're funny. You should only do this if you actually want to have the right approach, if you actually want to be positive, if you actually want to bring joy to other people, okay? Never trick people into thinking that you are something, someone you're not. Okay, so that was it for this episode. I hope it was interesting, and I hope that I helped you. With that said, see you guys.